So this is a book that is for educated Muslims, for uneducated Muslims, for an average Muslim, for a person who has a relation with the Quran, for a Muslim who doesn't have time to read the Quran, for a Muslim who feels disconnected completely and he wants to read something quick that gives him an overview of the Quran. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا إلى يوم الدين أما بعد In fact, the name of this book in Arabic is إرشاد ذوي الألباب لتدبر خير كتاب And for the ease of access to it in English, we decided to name it Contemplating the Quran because this is mainly what the theme of this book is about, to contemplate the Quran. The main motivation behind writing this book was the inaccessibility of the Quran to an average Muslim. Muslims nowadays have two barriers with the Quran. One is the language barrier. They don't read the Quran in Arabic. And the second barrier is translations of the Quran are kind of lengthy, and the length puts Muslims off from being able to read it. So I thought of a way or a method of how can I make it easy for Muslims to read a juz of the Quran a day without having to go to the text if they don't have the ability to do. If they have the ability to do that, that will be brilliant, but if they don't. So what I thought I should do is to summarize every juz of the Quran, the 30 ajza of the Quran, each one in 2 to 3 pages in a thematic way that makes a Muslim able to read in a quick way. Reflect on, if this Muslim is able to go and read the Quran itself, that would be brilliant. These summaries will help them understand the juz, and if not, then they have achieved something, and as they say, something is better than nothing. The layout of the book is quite simple. This book is meant to be read over a whole month. So if every Muslim is supposed to have a continuous relation with the Quran, and that relation, it would be better if it's over a month, and we have 30 ajza of the Quran. So what can Muslims do nowadays is to read at any time of the day, morning, evening, any time of the day, read the summary of the chapter of the Quran that is particular to this day and reflect on it. They can do that individually in the train when they're going to their workplace. They can do that in their own study, or they can do that with their families. So for example, in the month of Ramadan, in the 30 days of Ramadan, Muslims can gather with their families before iftar or after iftar or during the day, at any time of the day, and read the summary of the chapter or this particular to this day. In over a month, people can finish this if they want to be very systematic. It doesn't take more than 5 to 10 minutes, maximum 15 minutes to read and to reflect on each chapter. So the book is categorized according to the themes of the chapters. It's for any Muslim who's got ability to read and desire to read. The book is available in both Arabic and English, so the text that's available is bilingual text. Both are written in high classical language, so if someone reads Arabic, they can easily benefit from that, and they're definitely, as a byproduct, they will be able to push their language further with vocabulary, with style and stuff like that. In English, it's the same. I have heard a lot of readers coming back to me, and they said sometimes we had to open the dictionary a couple of times to check up or to look up a certain word. And one of the good things that we have received about the book is that the style flows really well, and people were kind of amazed at the language of the book in addition to the content. So this is a book that is for educated Muslims, for uneducated Muslims, for an average Muslim, for a person who has a relation with the Quran, for a Muslim who doesn't have time to read the Quran, for a Muslim who feels disconnected completely and he wants to read something quick that gives him an overview of the Quran.